Grenfell tragedy has been released by the judge Sir Martin Moorbrook, in which certain recommendations and highly critical of the command structure, the communications of the London Fire Brigade, not the personnel on the ground, but some of the command structures. There have been suggestions that in part the tragedy was caused by either racism or policies of class. Are these suggestions correct?
I don't think so. I think the tragedy came about because of the cladding leading to the fire racing up the building, and then was compounded by the stay put policy. And it seems to me that that is the tragedy of it, that the more one's read over the weekend about the report and about the chances of people surviving, if you just ignore what you're told and leave, you are so much safer. And I think if either of us were in a fire, whatever the fire brigade said, we would leave the burning building. It just seems the common sense thing to do, and it is such a tragedy that that didn't happen. But I don't think it's anything to do with race or class, and indeed I think it's rather sad to raise these types of points over a great tragedy. Nobody was,
well, it's a Labour MP who's doing it.
Nobody was
Emma Dent Code, the Labour MP,
but nobody,
it's racism or snobbery.
Nobody was evil in relation to this great tragedy, but people made mistakes, and humanity makes mistakes. And sometimes they have deeply tragic consequences. But it wasn't done because people had chips on their shoulder or they were bad people. They just got something terribly, terribly wrong.
In which case, can the Commissioner of the London Fire Brigade stay in post, Danny Cotton?
Well, I don't want to advise her personally on the choices that she should make, that she will read the report and she will come to a conclusion for herself. It's very easy for politicians to take pot shots at people making very difficult decisions. Would you or I have made a different decision in those circumstances? But I think the one thing we can do is say how much we admire the individual firefighters. I mean, can you imagine the bravery you need to go into a completely smoke-filled staircase with breathing equipment that is running out of oxygen and saving that final person that you managed to save? Their heroism should not be ignored, undermined, forgotten because of mistakes made at a higher level. And the mistake had tragic consequences, but I don't think was made by people because they were wicked. I think it was made by people because they thought they were doing the best.